As more and more scientific journals go electronic, researchers are getting greater opportunities to publish in color. When used purposively, color can enhance and clarify your figures. But when used without careful thought to design and intention, color can be confusing. It can hide the meaning of your data, or worse, even distort that meaning. Here at AJE, we understand that using color in your figures can be intimidating and confusing. So let's take a look at some of the most common questions you may have about using color in scientific figures. The color or colors that you choose are really up to you. Some researchers prefer a specific color palette and use it consistently throughout their work as a sort of branding. Others choose colors depending on how their data are related. For example, different shades of the same color can indicate closely related data, and an analogous palette can help illustrate similarities between different data sets. On the other hand, complementary colors or a triad scheme are good for highlighting differences between sets of data. One useful trick is to show one set of data in a completely different color to visually offset that information and guide the reader's eye. Although color has the ability to enhance your figures, it can also work against you. For example, using too many colors can be distracting and may obscure the meaning of your data. In addition, bright or neon colors such as yellow can be difficult to read against a light background. Another commonly overlooked problem when using color in figures is choosing color schemes that cannot be perceived by people who are colorblind. Colorblindness or color deficiency is the inability to see colors or differences in color under normal lighting conditions. The most common form of colorblindness is deuteranomaly, which is a reduced sensitivity to green light. This condition makes it difficult for people to distinguish between green and red hues. Globally, colorblindness affects approximately 8% of men and 0.5% of women, with countries such as India and Brazil among the most strongly affected. With a large amount of research taking place in these countries, it's reasonable to assume that someone reviewing or reading your paper will be affected by colorblindness and may be unable to interpret your data as intended. A few minor changes in how you present your data can ensure that they are accurately interpreted. For example, instead of using red and green, you can try using purple and green, or red and blue, or green and blue, or, well, you get the picture. Using color in figures can be an intimidating task, but understanding when and how to use the right color scheme can help enhance the clarity of your message. For more information about the use of color in figures, please read our white paper titled The Use of Color in Figures.